huh, nigga, this my shit. Welcome to the city of gods. Pop was the king of New York. Now I'm the nigga in charge. Only the drillers, the city is ours. Find out the odds when you pick them apart. I give them my time, so I give them my heart. If the city love me, then they're really a star.
Boy, just creating the vibes, man. That's all I'm doing before we get on the pod. I'm just creating the vibes, you know what I mean? We got to rock out to some music, man. That's on nasty. You niggas side-hop. If I want them to not let you come into the city, it's my option. This is the home of the fly shopping. This is where the bitches gonna watch pockets. When I'm on TV, I gotta look good, cause I know the whole block watcher. You chill with the ops, we's not following. I ain't forgot about Black History Month, though. We still celebrating Black History Month. I just had to take a break a little bit and enjoy a little bit of the foolishness, man. Comment on a little bit of the foolishness, conversate about the foolishness, but let's get back to it. Let's vibe out.
We going ultra. Yeah. We going ultra black. I got a toast to that. We don't fold the crack. We going. Occasion we rolls to that. Fuck on postal. We going ultra black. Watching the global change. Hopping the coldest range. Hit boy on the beat. This shit poster slap. We going ultra black. We going. We going.
Rhythm and blues. The Trevor Jackson Podcast.
Hey, man, how was y'all day, man? I hope everybody had a peaceful, productive, great day. Me, I had a good day, man. Worked out, went to work, got a couple of things accomplished. But what stuck out about my day today, the title of the show. It's pertaining to the title of the show. But I was having a conversation with a young man that I work with. Everybody, once they learn that I've been vegan for almost a decade now. It's six years. So when people find out, they always have a lot of questions. Be like, how do you eat this? Do you eat meat substitutes? What do you do about cheese? Everything don't have to be substituted. You got to enjoy things in their natural state. So I told them, I make cashews and water to make cheese substitute. But it's filling. You can't have a lot of it, though. That's heavy, cashews and water. So the young man said, man, I'm trying my best. It's just I can't give up meat. He said, I'm addicted to it. So when he said he was addicted to it, it caught my attention, and I just responded on just to keep the conversation going because I was enjoying it. About some things that I'm addicted to. And I was saying that I'm addicted to sugar, man. I said sugar is more addictive than cocaine. So he started laughing at me. He was like, nah, man. I said cocaine addicts, they just look bad. A sugar addict may not look bad, but sugar is way more addictive and it's way more accessible than cocaine. Like, you can't go a mile without a sugar substance or product being available to you. And people don't know that they're addicted to sugar until they attempt to leave it alone. And I'm one of those individuals. I found that the hard way. I tried to leave it alone. And when I tried to leave it alone, I was like, whoa. You had the shakes. You have a lot of things going on. It's crazy that you're not used to. And he said, man, I'm a see if I can try to do that. I said, nah, don't try to do it because I told you that I'm addicted to it and it's something that I deal with. Just continue on your journey, man, and enjoy yourself. I'm not one of those vegan people that, like, talk bad about people that ain't vegan or try to throw around like I'm better than you or something. Man, it's just a lifestyle that I chose to choose. But I'm going to get off of that, man. Hey, if you listening to the audio podcast at the audio platforms, come on over to YouTube, man. Subscribe to the channel and check out the visuals, man. We doing dope things over here. But let's create the vibes. We got a lot of topics to talk about. Let's go on and create the vibes, man. Hey, shout out to my boy Mike Shine that was on the podcast with me this previous Friday. I hope y'all enjoyed that Cabernet conversation because it was a dope discussion with my guy, man. Real dope. And he doing big things and we plan on making more moves together. But I wanted to create this podcast just to talk the talk. I wanted to talk about the mayor in New York City trying to ban drill, trying to ban a culture of a piece of art. Because I feel like all music is art. And that's why I played the Fabio Foreign song with Kanye West and Alicia Keys at the beginning of the show. Because I'm in support of the creators and all creators. But before we get into that, we're just gonna kick the shit, man. And we're going to talk about, like, the NBA All-Star. It just happened last night. Right now, it's 4:26 a.m. I'm conducting this podcast and this conversation because I just want to have some dope content to give out to my people and to my constituents, the people that listen to the channel and support the channel. And if you want to support the channel with donations, you can hit up the Cash App. It's scrolling at the bottom, Wavy Neutron. But, okay, what I noticed about the All-Star game that was different was the amount of injuries, the amount of people that wasn't playing. So, KD wasn't playing. James Harden wasn't playing. What's my boy? Dame Lillard wasn't playing. Anthony Davis wasn't playing. Draymond Green wasn't playing. It was so many people that wasn't playing. Then you had Chris Paul playing hurt. And that had people like, why is he playing hurt? It was just different. And what came to my mind and what came to my thoughts was like, what place is the NBA going to be in once LeBron James leaves? Like, on Skip and Shannon, they say he's Iron Man. He ain't never really been hurt, like, for a long amount of time. He's always available. Availability is the best ability. And a lot of people ain't available in the league right now. Ben Simmons, he didn't play in an All-Star game. Then my boy from Washington that's up for the max contract play, I didn't see him neither. Bradley Beal. You had a lot of people I didn't even, like, in the All-Star game that could be on the bench on their own team. But with that being said, like I was telling y'all, that my thoughts was like, what the NBA going to be like without LeBron? And, you know, after the All-Star game, TNT, they come on and talk, and they was giving their praises. I know the highlight is what Steph Curry did. He scored 50 points, and he broke the record again for the most three-point shots in the game. But the topic of discussion on TNT was LeBron and their perspective and the top 75 players. That was weird too, because some people, 75, that data, top 75, that was crazy. But Shaq and Chuck was talking and they mentioned something that was different, and we're gonna break it down after we check it out.
Coming in this NBA at 18, he's never been arrested. He's never embarrassed himself or his family. He's been the best player for a long time. In today's society where everybody's trying to get you, especially with the internet, I've said this before, not just now, I think he's had the most incredible career from an 18-year-old kid to come to the NBA, be one of the 5 or 10 greatest players, has never come close to getting into trouble. In today's society, I think it's amazing.
That's saying something.
I'm happy for LeBron. I first saw him in high school. He was magnificent. I knew when he came into the league, he was going to be a great player. I'm a little bit jealous of LeBron, and let me tell you why. We're all part of the Barbershop Talk. Greatest analyst, one of the greatest shooters, greatest power forward, one of the most dominant big men. But I would love to have my conversations the greatest of all time. I'm not in that conversation. He is. Kobe Bryant is. Michael Jordan is. And I ask people this all the time. Even I check this in LA. When he passes up Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in points, what you going to say about LeBron? Is he the greatest player of all time? Is he one of the greatest player? And I would also love to be in that position to where I'm the number one scorer. So happy for LeBron. I'm happy for his family. And it was a great day.
We got
to
get out the hip-hop thought
there is no greatest. There is just greatness. And we don't have to compare it. Just enjoy it.
First of all, I think, I've always said this, I think people who have that debate on television, I think they're lazy and have no talent.
I agree, Chuck. They're lazy and they have no talent. But, like, the greatest. The term is not even going to hold that much value no more if we just keep giving everybody the GOAT title. He's one of the GOATs. It's only one GOAT. The greatest of all time. And I agree with my boy Kenny. He said, we got to get out of the hip-hop mentality because the GOAT conversation and the GOAT acronym came up in hip-hop. LL Cool J created the acronym, the greatest of all time. He perceived that he was the greatest of all time. But all of those players that Shaq mentioned, Kobe, LeBron, and Michael Jordan, they all have three different, like, attributes that they added to the game. And the attributes that they added to the game was, it was just them. It was just genuinely them, like, I don't know what he was saying once he passed up Kareem, will he be the greatest? No. Mike always gonna be the greatest. He the only one that was willing to die on the court. That was gonna risk his life on the court. But like I said, before I played the clip, to me what LeBron, his greatest attribute was is that he took care of his health and he was his ability to be on the court, like just being available. Your availability is the best ability. He was available. He played. He played in a different time as Mike. But he's great. I agree. But the NBA All-Star was light, man. It was a light weekend to me. The dunk contest was trash. Skills challenge was trash. 3-point shooting contest, trash. The game, trash. What was cool, LeBron hit the game winning shot. Curry displayed his artistry. And the NBA, it's in a good place right now with Ja Morant and some of the young up and coming players, the Ball Boys, and Zion, they lose 100 pounds, but that's another thing. But when LeBron gone, I want to see the transition and will there ever even be somebody that lead the NBA like a Jordan, like a Kobe, like a LeBron, because I don't see people being that hungry no more to be the greatest, to fight and challenge to be the greatest. But before we get into this drill talk and everything, I want to go left for a minute. And I'm playing my music. I'm playing that Snake the Great. Y'all hear that? That's that Hustler Tale. And I know you don't want no beef. I be on the low, I don't blow no matter the cost. I stay true to all, stand tall, I never fall, nigga. From crack to rap about this crack. On social media yesterday, I pulled up, I still have hard copies to that album. But that album is 20 years old. It's a classic. And I'm not selling my hard copies I have left, because they're collector's items. If you want to pay for them, it's going to be like NFT prices, because it's one of a kind. Nobody else have them. So it ain't going to be the regular price for a CD. Just know that if you want to purchase any of them, or you hit me up. But one thing I want to talk about is my hometown. Like, I seen a picture of the new recruits of the police officers. And the first thing that was on my mind was that I never moved back to Knoxville. And then I had to be objective. Is black folks even attempting to be police officers? Are they even applying for the job? Is any other race besides white folks applying for the job in Knoxville, Tennessee? I'm not saying that it's like this worldwide or nationwide, but the picture was appealing to me. And I want to know y'all perspective. I'm going to play the picture and I'm going to get on to the next topic. But just get in the comment section and give me y'all perspective why it looked like this with the new recruits. That was crazy. Like, all Caucasian individuals, the new class of officer, all Caucasian individuals, like, should I feel protected and served in the city? Should I feel safe in the city when no one looks like me? Those are going to be the individuals patrolling the neighborhoods where the impoverished African-American people live, that don't know nothing about that neighborhood, that didn't grow up and go to the same high school as anybody from that neighborhood. I done seen it over and over again in the K. But we off that. We off that. What I was looking at today, like I always listening to podcasts or videos, or I'm listening to audiobooks. So I was listening to Joe Budden. He was talking about Pusha T. Pusha T warming up the streets. He just shot the video Diet Coke, released the single Diet Coke. So he was on Complex. I seen the promotion. I see him on his run. And he was on $1 million worth of game. And he mentioned something about being accessible. And I just told y'all availability is the best ability in sport. But he was talking about being accessible. And I think about this when I release these podcasts. I really do. I think that I just want to go to a website or to YouTube or only something only. I don't want to be as accessible as I have been, because I feel like I'm too reachable. You can get access to me too easy, and I don't like it. And I remember a time when hip hop artists seemed like you can't get close to them. They ain't on Instagram all day. They ain't going live. They ain't always got something to say. Like, they would drop something and they'll disappear, and then when they reappear, you'll be excited to hear some new music. I remember Fab used to be like that. Now I can go on Instagram and see the outfit that he got on every day. I remember it was a plethora of artists used to be like that. Nas, he used to drop and disappear. He'll drop, do his press run, and then you wouldn't hear from him until the next album came out. And it seemed like those people wasn't just easily accessible. But now, you take the want to hear more, to see more away. When you're so easily accessible through social media, people now don't care about quality music. They don't care about they don't care about how good the music is, or releasing a classic, or being the best. Like, the people that's famous now and making music now are personalities. Internet personalities, Instagram personalities, and they drop a trash record and make millions of dollars off of it. But Pusha T said something that caught my attention on $1 million worth of game. For real.
You don't spread yet, but you is less is more. You don't spread just say you're a boutique out here. What is the importance of that shit? It's like they can't find you, they can't reach you. You're unreachable.
Yeah. I try to be.
And it's like I think a lot of us with social media, we think being everywhere is being everywhere. And a lot of times being everywhere is being nowhere, because you become regular.
Mm-hmm.
What is the importance of that, and where did you get that from?
Man, I just feel like if I ain't got nothing to say, then I don't want to really be in the mix talking about nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, I could have been came on $1 million worth of game, you know what I'm saying? You know, but like, let's come up here for a reason. Let's really talk about shit. And like, you know, it's new music coming. It's shit happening. I'm not really one just to be outside, just to be outside. Mm-hmm. Like, I've been outside. Like, I'm now, like, really just focusing on the future and my craft and, like, what's going to take me to the next level, what's going to take my people to the next level.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of people really do be on social media, like, and they spread themselves thin. And I guess, you know, it works for some people. I just don't think it works for me because I don't have something to say every day. Like, I don't even.
Jay-Z, he's not accessible on the internet. Who some more people, y'all? Get in the comment section, talk to me, talk back to me. Who are some more people that's not easily accessible on the internet? It's value in that, and it's also value in being on it. But what is for you? Like, that shit can get overwhelming. I talked on a previous podcast about mental health and Roddy Ricch deleting his Instagram. Like, sometimes being accessible isn't healthy for you. It's not good for you. It doesn't benefit you. But some people lose themselves in it. But we're going to get on into the last topic, man. Like, drill music. The mayor getting involved. He just recently sat down with Mano and Favio and a couple other artists from New York. And my perception is, like, music is just a form of expression. And most of the time, these people be expressing their reality. It was once upon a time when it was booty music, Uncle Luke. And all them boys, 69 boys, 2-0, 2-0. They was just talking about that lifestyle in Miami. It's genres of music inside of hip hop. You have crunk music. That was the club era when people was in the club drinking energy drinks and alcohol at the same time and wilding out. Crunk music. That was their reality. Trap music. That was the drug era. That was when people was talking about selling drugs, and that was the reality at the time. What is it? What's the 6ix9ine era? Clout era. The clout era. You had the conscious era, the hip hop era, the, you know what I mean? It was just, it's just different forms of people reality. But then at one point in time, The people that's my age or a little bit older or younger, or no, just my age or older, we wanted people to keep it real. We was like, we tired of these fake rappers and tired of this fake hip hop and all of that. Now we want all rappers to be fake. Now we complaining about them being real, really shooting folks, really killing folks. We complain about that, but then we was complaining about them being fake. We can't have it both ways now. You know what I'm saying? We want them real, or do we want them fake? We gonna always be complaining. For real. Because drill is the reality. That murder shit. I'm smoking my ops. I'm killing this nigga. We dissing each other. He respond back. I gotta smoke him. And I gotta kill him after he's dead. Again, in another record. But let's listen to what the mayor had to say and what the mayor's plans was to do before he sat down with Favio and Mano.
No idea what drill rapping was, but I called my son and he sent me some videos, and it is alarming. And we are going to pull together the social media companies and sit down with them and state that you have a civic and corporate responsibility. You know, I mean, we pulled Trump off Twitter because of what he was spewing. Yet we are allowing music, displaying of guns, violence. We're allowing it to stay on these sites because look at the victims. We're bringing them in. We're going to show exactly what is being displayed. And we are alarmed by it. We are alarmed by the use of social media to really over-proliferate this violence in our community.
To over-proliferate. And then he said, what is his connection with social media to be able to go to them and ask them to take people's creativity off of their platforms? Freedom of speech ain't free no more. Then you got YouTube algorithmic things, and they saying that they're going to start blocking people's videos because of propaganda. Freedom of speech ain't free no more. All the 10 or whatever them commandments is, whatever the, they ain't not the 10 commandments, but the amendments or whatever. I'm tipsy right now. I'm going off that Cabernet, but freedom of speech ain't free. That's all I got to say. And that mayor, you ain't winning no more terms, dog. Because you need the black vote. You need the people that you denouncing to vote for you. And they're just speaking their reality. What are you doing to make their reality different? That's the key. Hey, thank y'all for tuning in, man. You know what time it is. Peace, love, plenty, abundance. Make sure you go get you some money. I'm out.